a little bit more formally about it and less preachy. Oh, and I did find, I forgot about the sizeage. In Texas, it's there's a sizeage between beer and chicken fried steak. So if you're ever in Texas, that's just what you have to know. That's, nobody eats ever. So anyway, and you know that. Does anybody have a question?
Can you talk about the reactions that you have received? There was a mention about a poem that a child wrote.
I did.
What things that you were moved by in people's reactions to this?
I had to, you know, when I first came out with this painting, it was sort of ill at ease. It's sort of like Hume said, kind of, I wanted a ticker tape parade, and it kind of sat there for a while, you know, and you kind of think, well, I did this, and I want people to jump up and down. And what has been wonderful about this painting, where he says it's been the most extraordinary thing in my life, is we've had this sort of grassroots thing. And I knew it was going to happen because I was walking up the stairs, the grand staircase of the New Britain Museum of Art, and a person who's, you know, about 80 years old grabbed my hand and she goes, "You have got to see Graydon Parrish's new painting." It was probably one of the most wonderful moments of my life. Because I paint for people, and I don't paint for, I would love the moment to take it, but I paint for people who like, you know, you. I'm a kind of that sort of artist that I want people to like it. I try to couch it in, there's a lot of meaning and stuff I put into this painting, and it may come out wanting a little bit of that, but I think I want people to like art again. It is imperative for me that the more people that like art, the more pauses we'll get and the more empathy we'll get in the world. And I don't want people to be like this and feel beat up. So I've had somebody come in and there have been proposals. I got a wonderful poem from an 11-year-old. I got my, it was, came out on the cover of a textbook on terror poetry in India. I have a person that writes me every almost once a week from Turkey. He goes to an internet cafe. I have students that come, and I just got a letter yesterday for somebody that said it because they were very moved by my work. So what Venice has sort of, you know, wrapped up on the ocean has become a quite, which looked to me like a creek, has become an ocean of all kinds of interactions. And that's going to be a pleasant thing. Anybody else? You're going to be great in all these questions.
It isn't a question so much as a statement. Mm-hmm. Back in 1944, anybody who might remember the Hartford Circus fire?
Oh yeah.
I lost my aunt, took me there, and I lost it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
When I look at this, it reminds me.
Well, that's how I feel, thank you. I mean, as far as being, I like people being moved. Thank you for being moved. I cry, I'm one of those people who can cry in front of a painting, because it's the warehouse of recollections. We need paintings to remember us. We need paintings.
The only way she was identified was by an address that my mother made her, and my mother had material left over, which my father and his brothers went to the gym there with all the bodywork, and so
I'm sorry.
Recognized her.
Thank you.
By the material.
Yeah,
it's everybody in the family has a piece of that material.
It's like the quilt that people pass around the way. It's wonderful.
But this reminds me of that, and I'm warm.
Thank you. That's really good. I'm going to go home now. Thank you.
Thank you. My question is, the Mona Lisa, the artist is extremely attached to that, whoever other paintings before he died. Which paintings are you very attached to in this time?
To my next point. I'm not letting that go.
I'm always very impressed when I see paintings like this about the challenges of painting skin. Because I think that's so difficult to do.
You asked my student Victoria, who's here, and it's an elusive thing.
Right.
And it has to do with color. It's a thing that our lizard brains tells us it's really important, but it occupies only about that much on the color wheel, a sliver. And if you go too far on one side, you look like you've been sunbathing too much in the Bahamas. On the other side, you look like you just checked into the morgue. This is a very, very narrow range of color. But they're all, that's what's hard about it. And it's a lot of just very subtle things.
Beautiful.
Well, thank you. Anybody else?
Are
friend that did one, and I don't think it was of this size. Unfortunately, art, I think, needs to get its chops back to talk about human experiences. I encourage people to come back time to time and look at the New Britain Museums of Art illustration collection, because the illustrators, in the midst of abstract expressionism, the people that have documented the 20th century, a lot of times with illustrators, and they're very important. And I think Norman Rockwell and J.C. Leyendecker and Christie told us a lot about, and Bentham told us a lot about the world. And I think it's time now for painters to once again attach themselves to important events. That's my opinion. You can tell me your choice. anybody else? It's a wonderful gift that you're here. Thank you. It's very moving. I don't know what to say. All you attending, everybody, let's just go dream and have some fun. But yes, I'm finding people stuck down there.